Now we can see what is called indirect proof. Assume that, otherwise suppose that, instead of assume, we can use the word suppose also. Assume that the statement to be proved is false. Begin to do the proof assuming that the statement to be proved is false. Then at one step you will get a contradiction. Hence our assumption is wrong. So the given statement, the given consequent is true. Once again I am telling what is called indirect proof. Assume that the statement to be proved is false. Begin to do the proof assuming that the statement to be proved is false. Then at one step you will get a contradiction. Hence our assumption goes wrong. So the given consequent is true. Now study the following example. A prime number greater than 2 is odd. The conditional statement of this statement is, if p is a prime number greater than 2, then it is odd. This is a if-then statement. So the given part will be, if we are taking p to be the prime number greater than 2, then to prove p is an odd number. So given statement is, p is a prime number greater than 2. We are going to prove p is an odd number. Now see the given statement. P is a prime number greater than 2. So that is 1 and P will be the only divisors of P. P is a prime number. So 1 and P are the only divisors of P. Now how to do the proof? We have to prove P is an odd number. Now we are going to prove by indirect proof method. So we have to suppose. Suppose means assume that P is not an odd number. We have to prove that P is an odd number. So by indirect proof method, when you are doing the proof, we have to suppose that P is not an odd number. So if P is not an odd number, P will be an even number. All of you know that if a number is not an odd number, then it will be an even number. So you know that a divisor of P will be 2 by all means because it is an even number. But it is given that P is a prime number greater than 2. In the given statement we have P is a prime number greater than 2. Therefore 1 and P are the only divisors of P. Statements 1 and 2 are contradictory. What is the statement 1 telling? A divisor of P is 2. What is the statement 2? Therefore, 1 and P are the only divisors of P. These two are contradictory statements. Therefore, the assumption that P is not odd is false. What we assumed is false. So the given consequent is true. So this proves that a prime number greater than 2 is odd. So we have proved that P is an odd number.
Problem set 1, page number 11, question number 7. Write the following statements in conditional form. Every rhombus is a square. You have to write of the form if then. If a quadrilateral is a square, then it is a rhombus. Angles in a linear pair are supplementary. If the angles are in a linear pair, then they are supplementary. A triangle is a figure formed by three segments. If a figure is a triangle, then it is formed by three segments. A number having only two divisors is called a prime number. If a number has only two divisors, then it is a prime number. Practice at 1.3, page number 11. You have to write out the if-then form. The opposite angles of a parallelogram are congruent. If a quadrilateral is a parallelogram, then its opposite angles are congruent. The diagonals of a rectangle are congruent. If a quadrilateral is a rectangle, then its diagonals are congruent. In an isosceles triangle, segment joining the vertex and the midpoint of the base is perpendicular to the base. If a triangle is an isosceles triangle, then the segment joining the vertex and the midpoint of the base is perpendicular to the base. you have to write of the format of if then. Write converses of the following statements. The alternate angles formed by two parallel lines and the transversal are congruent. If so, we have to write vice versa. If statement is containing some data, that will go to the then statement, and then statement will become the if statement. If the alternate angles formed by two lines and their transversal are congruent, then the lines are parallel. Antecedent will become consequent, and consequent will become antecedent for the converses. If two parallel lines are intersected by a transversal, then the interior angles so formed are supplementary. The diagrams of a rectangle are congruent. If the diagonals of a quadrilateral are congruent, then the quadrilateral is a rectangle. Problem set 1, page 11. Write the converse of each of the following statements. Antecedent should be written as consequent, and consequent will become antecedent. If a figure is a triangle, then the sum of the measures of all the angles of this figure is 180 degrees. If the sum of the measures of two angles is 90 degrees, then they are complement of each other. So now here also make antecedent as consequent and consequent as antecedent. So if two angles are complement of each other, then the sum of their measures is 90 degrees. For the third question also make the antecedent as consequent and the consequent as antecedent. Similarly for the fourth one. If the sum of the digits of a number is divisible by 3, then the number is divisible by 3. So it will become, if a number is divisible by 3, then the sum of the digits of the number is divisible by 3. Problem set 1, page 11. Write the antecedent, that is the given part, and the consequent part to be proved in the following statements. If all sides of a triangle are congruent, then its all angles are congruent. Antecedent will be all sides of a triangle are congruent, and consequent will be all angles of the triangle are congruent. The diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. The antecedent will be, that is what is to given will be a quadrilateral is a parallelogram, and what part is to be proved is diagonals bisect each other. The question number 10. We have to draw the figure and write the antecedent and consequent. Two equilateral triangles are similar. We are given two triangles. Two equilateral triangles are similar. So now, construct two equilateral triangles. One triangle I have named it as ABC. The other triangle I have named it as PQR. So we have to draw the figure. We have to label it properly. Because they are equilateral triangles, I have shown the In the diagram, I have shown the labeling. I have marked the equal parts by similar markings. In the second figure, PQR, because it's an equilateral triangle, I have to mark PQ is equal to PR is equal to QR in the figure. By mistake, that marking is not done, please do it. Mark QR for QR also the same marking as how I have done for PQ and PR. Because it is an equilateral triangle. Triangle PQR is an equilateral triangle. Show the marking properly for all three sides. In the figure it is missed out. So you have to do it. Mark PQ. What marking I have done for PQ and PR. Mark for QR in the figure. Now write the solution. You have to write the antecedent and the consequent for this. Antecedent means the given statement. We are given two equilateral triangles. And the consequent is what is to be proved. We have to prove that two equilateral triangles are similar. So, antecedent will be the given thing, that is two triangles are equilateral. We are given that two triangles are equilateral. Triangle ABC, that is triangle ABC is an equilateral triangle, and triangle PQR is another equilateral triangle. So ABC and PQR are equilateral triangles. Please do the marking properly in the second figure in triangle PQR. Mark how I mark for PQ, PR. In the same way you do the marking for QR, it is missed out in the figure. So antecedent is the given part. Two equilateral triangles are similar is the statement which is given to you, and you have to write the antecedent and the consequent. You have to write the given part and the part which is to be proved. If you do not know to write this given and to prove, then you cannot solve any problem in mathematics in 9th standard, because all theorem and proofs are based on this format. First you have to write what is given and then you have to prove. So to prove, we have to write what is to be proved. So antecedent is the given part and consequent is the part to be proved. So in this statement, two equilateral triangles are similar. The given part is two triangles are equilateral. That's it. So you have to write in the notation form now, that is triangle ABC and triangle PQR are equilateral triangles. So we have two triangles ABC and PQR to be equilateral. Have you understood the antecedent? How to write? So here you are asked to, in the 10th question, you are asked to draw the figure on your own. So figure will not be given for this question. You have to draw a labeled figure. You have to label it showing information in each of the following statements and write the antecedent and the consequent. So first of all, you have to draw the figure, then write the antecedent and then the consequent. Draw two equilateral triangles. Show the markings on them and label it properly. Marking for QR is not given, please do it. And write the antecedent. That is the given thing. What is given in the question? Two triangles are equilateral. That is, triangle ABC and triangle PQR are equilateral triangles. You have to prove these two triangles are similar. You have to prove these two triangles are similar. So that will be the consequent. There is a symbol for similar. You have to use that symbol for similar and write triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. See how to write now. when you are further doing the problems, in that is when you are solving theorems, you will be writing the given statement first. Then you will be writing what is to be proved, that is in the format of to prove, that is the consequent here. And then you will do the proof. So for that, for training you for doing further theorems, this question number 10 is helping you. So you have to learn it properly. It is very important, the 10th question. So a star mark is put on this 10th question. Now antecedent is the given part and consequent is the part to be proved. So we have to prove that triangles are similar. So triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. And the notation for similar, you have to write properly the notation for similar. You learned already how to write congruent. Now learn how to write the notation for similar triangles. So triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR is the consequent. See the second question. If angles in a linear pair are congruent, then each of them is a right angle. You have to draw the figure. Here we should not show the right angle on the figure because it is the part to be proved. What is given only should be shown on the figure. You are given only the word congruent. Angles in a linear pair are congruent, that is the antecedent. That is angle ABC is congruent to angle CBD. So we have to show only the marking for congruence. So equal angles are of equal measures, so show the marking in the figure. What is to be proved should not be shown in the figure. We have to prove that the two angles are right angles, so each is of measure 90 degrees. Now third question, if the altitude is drawn on two sides of a triangle are congruent, then those two sides are congruent. You show the altitudes to be congruent, and because their altitudes show the foot of the perpendicular as 90 degrees. Write the antecedent now. Antecedent is the given part. The altitudes drawn on two sides of a triangle are congruent is the given part. Now we have to write it in the format of the notation. How to write? That is, the altitudes drawn on the two sides of the triangle are congruent. We have taken the altitudes, but it is not labeled properly. So labeled on the figure, where B is starting, no, for the altitude. Give the naming. For the foot of the perpendicular, the name is not given on the figure. You have to name it. Name it on the figure also, it is missing the figure. Name the foot of the perpendiculars. Now this is segment BM, so name the foot of the perpendiculars M in the figure. In triangle ABC, segment BM is one altitude. So segment BM is perpendicular to side AC. segment BM is perpendicular to side AC. So mark the foot of the perpendicular as M in the figure. Antecedents are given part. See, the given statement is, if the altitudes drawn on two sides of a triangle are congruent, then those two sides are congruent. I'm reading it once again. If the altitudes drawn on two sides of a triangle are congruent, then those two sides are congruent. You have to take a triangle, it is given. So I have taken the triangle ABC. And the altitudes drawn are BM and CN. But the marking is not given in the figure, so you have to mark it. You label it as BM and CN. The label the altitudes as BM and CN. Altitudes means heights. So now here, the foot of the perpendicular for the first altitude is M. The foot of the perpendicular for the second altitude is N. Mark it on the figure. So now antecedent is the given part. So when you are proving theorems, you will be given a statement. Prove that the altitude drawn on two sides of the triangle, if altitude drawn on two sides of the triangle are congruent, then those two are congruent. You will be given a statement like this. Then you will be drawing the figure. You will be writing the given part and the part to be proved. Antecedent is the given part. Here, altitudes drawn on two sides of a triangle are congruent is the given part in the given statement. And what is the part to be proved? Those two sides are congruent, you have to prove. That will be the consequent. Now consider the antecedent. After if, the statement goes like this. The altitudes drawn on two sides of a triangle are congruent. After if, the statement which follows will be the antecedent. I am taking much time to explain this question because it is very important for the further lessons. When we go to the further lessons, you will be having so many theorems to be proved. So the format is, first you draw the figure, then write what is given and what is to be proved. Then only you can do the proof. So now we should know how to write the antecedent. Antecedent is the given part. So here the given part is going after if what is coming, that is the given part. Altitudes drawn on two sides of a triangle are congruent. So you have to write this in the format of the notations. It is very important to write in the format of notations. You will get marks for that. If you are simply writing altitudes drawn on two sides of a triangle are congruent, nobody will give you marks for the theorems. You have to write that data, given data, in notations. So here we are writing, because we have taken segment BM and segment CN to be the altitudes, we are writing segment BM is perpendicular to side AC, where M lies between A and C. We have to mention where M is lying. It is not on either side of A and C. It is lying in between A and C. So you have to write A hyphen M hyphen C. That means betweenness. You have learned betweenness in the first lecture itself. So you will understand the meaning of this. A hyphen M hyphen C. That means M lies between A and C. Similarly, you have the next line to be written. What is the next altitude? It is segment CN. Please mark N in the foot of the perpendicular in the figure. Don't forget. So here, for this altitude, CN, in the foot of the perpendicular we have N. So segment CN is the altitude which is perpendicular to side AB. And here, which point lies between which one and which one? Here N lies between A and B. So you have to write it as A hyphen N hyphen P. I think all of you would have understood how to write. When you're writing the altitudes drawn on two sides of the triangle, you will get two statements like this. So in triangle ABC, you have to mention in which triangle it is. No, so you have to write the triangle also. So in triangle ABC, segment BM is perpendicular to side AC, and M lies between A and C. Segment CN is perpendicular to side AB, and N lies between A and B. Now we have to write the congruent also, no? So these two altitudes are congruent. So how to write in the notation format? Segment BN is congruent to segment CN. So we have written the antecedent. We have completed writing the antecedent. We have written all details in notation form for this statement, altitudes drawn on two sides of a triangle are congruent. Now we'll write the consequent. Consequent means what is to be proved. We have to prove that those two sides are congruent. Which two sides? Side AC and side AB. In the given statement, we have written that in detail. Side AC and side AB is coming, no? So those two sides are congruent. We have to write the consequent. That is what is to be proved. Those two sides are congruent. Which two sides? Side AC and side AB. So we have to write in the format of notation. Side AC is congruent to side AB, you can write. Otherwise, side AB is congruent to side AC also, you can write. So now look at how to write the congruent symbol. Side AB is congruent to side AC. Congruence and similarity are different. So see the symbol properly and write. This is the symbol for congruence. Now look at this question. This is the first question in the problem set. You have to check the answer after solving them on your own. Very simple questions they are, so you can do it on your own. Fourth one and fifth one of our homework.